morning students, class 7th. Next topic is decimals. So first of all, we will discuss what is the decimals. Decimals means, let us suppose if any number is written as 3, 4, decimal 5, 2, then this is a decimal number. So what is the decimal? Fractions with the denominators 10 or power of 10, that is whether the denominator is 100 or 1000 or 10,000 or 1 lakh, then such fractions are known as decimal. For example, if 1 is divided by 10, then it can be written as decimal 1. Why? If in denominator after 1, if the number of zeros are 1, 2, 3 or 4, then to convert such fraction into decimal, first we will count the number of 0, and in numerator number of equal to 0, we will count the digit, and before such number of digit, we will put a decimal point. So 1 upon 10 can be written as decimal 1. And 1 upon 100 can be written as decimal 01. Similarly, 1 upon 1000 can be written as decimal 001. And 1 upon 10,000 can be written as decimal 0001. So, if in denominator only 1 0, then in numerator before 1 digit we will put decimal. If in denominator there are 2 0, then in numerator before 2 digit we will put decimal. So here only 1 digit, so before 1 first we will write 0 and then we will put decimal. Similarly, 1 upon 1000, then after removing denominator, in numerator before 1 we will put 2 0 and then put the decimal. Similarly, 1 upon 10,000, then here number of 0 are 4, so before 4 digits, so 1 0 0 0 and then we will put decimal. So, ऐसी fractions जिनका denominator 10 या 10 की power हो, उनको हम decimals के form में represent कर सकते हैं। अब अगर हमें कोई number दे रखा है, let us suppose 53.048, then the number which is the group of number which is just before two decimal is known as whole part और कंप्लीट पार्ट। सो किसी भी डेसिमल नंबर में डेसिमल के जस्ट पहले वाला कंप्लीट पार्ट, जैसे 53.048 में जो 53 है, दैट इज कॉल्ड कंप्लीट पार्ट और होल पार्ट। एंड द ग्रुप ऑफ डिजिट्स व्हिच जस्ट आफ्टर द डेसिमल, दैट इज इन राइट साइड टू द डेसिमल, कंप्लीट पार्ट इज नॉट ए नॉन एज डेसिमल पार्ट। सो इन एनी गिवन डेसिमल नंबर देर आर टू पार्ट, बिफोर डेसिमल नंबर्स आर नॉन एज होल पार्ट एंड आफ्टर डेसिमल आर नॉन एज डेसिमल पार्ट। और इन सिंपली वी कैन से आफ्टर डेसिमल दैट इज राइट हैंड साइड इज नॉन एज डेसिमल पार्ट एंड द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज नॉन एज होल पार्ट। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन 34.52, this 34 is whole part and this 52 is known as decimal part. So this is about the whole part and decimal part. Now what do you understand by decimal places? Decimal places ka matlab kisi bhi decimal number mein decimal ke baad jitne digit hote hain, un digit ki sankhya is known as decimal places. So what is the decimal places? The number of digit contained in its decimal part. For example, 278.43. So here in decimal part there are two number. That is first is 4, second is 3. But we should not see that what is the number. Just we have to count ki after decimal how many digits are there. So there are in 278.43 में टू डिजिट है, सो दिस इज टू डेसिमल प्लेसेस है। अगर मैं कोई दूसरा एग्जांपल लेता हूं 159.875, Then in decimal part, there are three digits. So this is three decimal places. So decimal places means number of digits contained in decimal part is known as decimal places. Now next, what do you understand by like decimal? Like decimals means if some decimals are given and in the given decimal numbers, if the number of digits in the decimal part are equal, for example, 5.92, here decimal part is 92, so the number of digits are 2. Similarly, in 62, decimal 03, number of decimal places in the decimal part are again 2. Similarly, in 579, decimal 17, the decimal part, the number of decimal places are 2. So, if in the given decimal numbers, the number of decimal places are equal, for example, here 2 decimal places, in this also 2 decimal places, and here also 2 decimal places. So, if number of decimal places in the some given decimal numbers are equal, then such decimals are known as like decimal. And those decimals, numbers in which in the decimal part, number of decimal places are different, then such decimals are known as like decimal. For example, in 2.394, the decimal places are 3. 6.02, the decimal places are 2. 5.7, the decimal places are 1. So here 3 decimal places, here 2 decimal places, in this decimal only 1 decimal places. So everywhere decimal places number are different. So such decimals will be termed as unlike decimal, and jinme decimal places ki sankhya equal ho unko kya bolenge apan, decimal like decimals. Now one more important, that's very important, that is writing number of zeros at the end of decimal that does not change the value of decimal. Means let us suppose one decimal number is given, 7.5, that is 7.5. Now the decimal part is 0.5, that is 5. In any given decimal, at the end of decimal, if we put 0, for example 7.50, 7.500, 7.500, then such old decimal will be equal, because at the end of decimal, if we put 0, then decimal value will not change. Similarly, 89.063, if we write 89.0630 or 89.06300, then these decimals value will not change. So this was about decimals, whole part of decimal and decimal part, like decimal, unlike decimal, and if we put 0 at the end of decimal, then decimals value will not change. So please pause the video and note down. Yes, the next is the place value table for decimals. Let us suppose if we have given any number, for example, the decimal number is 578.396, which is in the standard form, then how we will read out the decimals and what will be the whole part and what will be the decimal part of this standard decimal number. So the place value table for decimals, after the decimal, the first digit is known as tens, the next digit is known as hundreds, and then next digit is known as thousands. Similarly, in whole part, from decimal, first is known as ones, then second one is known as tens, and then next one is known as hundreds. Each place is 10 times its neighbor on the right side, and each place is 1 by 10 of its neighbor on the left side. So tens means whatever the digit at tens, that will be multiplied by 1 by 10, and hundreds means the digit which is at the hundredth, that will be multiplied by 1 by 100. and the digit which is a thousands place, that will be multiplied by 1 by 1000. Similarly, just we put the decimal, the digit which at ones will be multiplied by 1, the digit at the tens will be multiplied by 10, and the digit at hundreds will be multiplied by hundreds. So let us consider one example of a decimal number, that is 578.396. Then the tens digit in given decimal number is 3, the hundreds number is, the digit at hundredth is 9, and the digit at thousands is 6. And similarly, in whole part, the digit at ones is 8, the digit at tens is 7, and the digit at hundreds is 5. So if we have to write this given decimal number in the expanded form, then first we will write, expanded form will be equals to, in the whole part, the digit at hundreds is 5, so it will be written as 5 into 100, plus the digit at tens is 7, so this will be multiplied by 7 into 10, that it will be 70, plus the digit at ones is 8, so it will be multiplied by 1. Then plus of the digit at tens, that is just after the decimal, first place digit is 3, so it will be multiplied by 1 by 10. Then digit at hundredth is 9, so it will be multiplied by 1 by 100. And the digit at thousandth is 6, so it will be multiplied by 6 into 1000. So in this way, if there is any decimal number, then in expanded form, how we will write it? First, we will see the whole part, and then we will see the decimal part. In whole part, the ones will be multiplied by 1, the digit at tens will be multiplied by 10, and the digit at 100 is multiplied by 100. So 500 plus 70 plus 8 plus, in the decimal part, the digit at tens, that is just after the decimal point, the first digit is known as 10, so this digit will be multiplied by 1 by 10, the digit at hundreds is multiplied by 1 by 100, and the digit at thousands will be multiplied by 1000. So 3 into 1 by 10 plus 9 into 1 by 100 plus 6 into 1 by 100. In this way, any decimal number can be written in the expanded form. So one more example, let us suppose if we have given a decimal number in standard form is 659.3492. Then in expanded form, how we will write? The complete part is, or the whole part is 659, and the decimal part is 392. In any decimal number, after the decimal or the decimal part will be always read out as in single digit, just like 392. We will never speak 392. The number which is in decimal part will be speak out as separately. So 659 is the whole part and 392 is the decimal part. Now its expanded form will be, the digit at hundreds is 6, so 6 into 100, that is 600. The digit at 10 is 5, so 5 into 10, that is 50. Plus digit at 1 is 9, so 9 into 1, that is 9. Plus the digit at 10th place, in that is the first decimal place, in the decimal part will be multiplied by 1 by 10. And the digit at hundreds, that is 9, so it will be multiplied by 100. Plus the digit at thousands is 2, so 2 will be multiplied by 1000. 2 into 1 upon 1000. So this is the expanded form. Please pause the video and note down. The next topic is fraction to decimal, or if we have a given number in fraction form, then how we will convert in decimal. So when fraction is given, then we will divide numerator by denominator. For example, if the fraction is given 7 upon 8, and if you convert it into decimal, then we will divide the 7 by 8. So here 7 is cannot be divided by 8, so first we will put a decimal, and against decimal we will take a 0. So now dividend is 70 and divisor is 8. Now 8 is a 64, remainder is your 6. Against this decimal again we will put 1 point, so it will be equals to 0. Now 8 7 is 56, again remainder is 4. Against the decimal we will put 10. 8 5 is 40. So now remainder is 0. So 7 upon 8 is equals to decimal 875. So in this way, if we have given any fraction, then we can convert the given fraction into decimal. For one more example, let us suppose if we have to convert one fraction is 1 upon 2 in the decimal, then what we will do, we will divide 1 by 2. So here again 2 can, 1 it cannot be divided by 2, so put decimal here in quotient. Against 1 decimal we can put 10. So now 2 5s are 10, so 10 minus 10 it will be 0. So 1 upon 2 is equals to decimal 5. So in this way, if any fraction is given, then we can convert the given fraction in decimal. Now next point is comparing the decimal. When we have given two decimal number and if we have to compare that which one is small and which one is greater, then to compare the decimal number, first of all we will compare the whole part in the given decimal. For example, one decimal number is 29.082 and another decimal number is 17.996. And if you have to compare that whether this one is greater or this one, then in both, first we will see that in the first fraction the whole part is 29 and in the second fraction the whole part is 17. So in the given two decimal number, if the whole part of one decimal number is greater than the another decimal number, then the decimal number whose whole part is greater will be greater than the another number. So this decimal number will be greater than this decimal. One more example. For example, this one is the 8.937 and this one is 10.035. So which one is greater? In the first decimal number, the whole part is 8 and in the second decimal number, the whole part is 10. So the whole part of second decimal number is greater. So this second decimal number will be greater than the first decimal number. So in comparing the two decimal number, first we will compare the whole part, and if the whole part are equal, then we will compare the decimal part. Now if the whole part are same, then compare the decimal part. So in these two given decimal number, the whole part are equal. So now we will compare the decimal part. And in the decimal part, first we will compare the first decimal place in the both decimal part. So in first decimal number, the first decimal place is 1 and in second the first decimal place is 3. So 3 is greater than 1, implies that this decimal number will be greater than this decimal number. Similarly, in these two decimal numbers, the whole part is equal, so we will compare the decimal part, and in the decimal part, first decimal places in the both the decimal numbers are same, that is 7 7, so 7 equal to 7. So then we will compare the second decimal place, and the second decimal place in the first number is 8, which is greater than the second decimal place, which is 3 in the second decimal number. So this decimal will be greater than this. Now one more example. For this, in this decimal here, see, the whole part is 2 in the both, so it is equal. Now the first decimal place is 0 in the both, then the second decimal place is 7 in the both, and the third decimal place, that is 6, is greater than 4. So this 2 decimal 076 is greater than 2 decimal 074. So in this way we can convert a given fraction into decimals and we can compare the decimals. So in comparing the given two decimal number. First we will see the whole part and then we will see the decimal part. So hope you like this video. Please like it, share it and subscribe it. In next video, we will do the exercise on this decimal. Thank you.